Hello dear students, as I told you in the previous lecture, today we will start with the first topic of your animal diversity paper, which is locomotion in protozoa. So in case of actively locomoting protozoans, they may have any one out of these three types of locomotory organelle, and out of these today we will take up locomotion with the help of pseudopodium with reference to amoeba. So first let us know a little about amoeba, which is a freshwater microscopic organism belonging to the kingdom Protista and the subkingdom or the phylum Protozoa. The species of amoeba, which will be our reference species during this topic, is Proteus. Amoeba Proteus is commonly called as the little Proteus. As far as the morphology of amoeba is concerned, being a member of Kingdom Protista, it is a unicellular eukaryotic organism, jiska matlab hai that it is a eukaryote and sara ka sara organism, it consists of only one cell. The outermost membrane or the plasma membrane of amoeba is termed as plasma lemma, and inner to plasma lemma is present its protoplasm or the cytoplasm, which is further divided into two parts, out of which the outer comparatively thin layer, which consists of the firm and non-granular part, is referred as ectoplasm, and inner granular part is termed as endoplasm, which is further divided into plasma gel and plasma sole. Plasma gel, as the name indicates, it is comparatively gelatinous part, and plasma sole is the inner part, which is fluidy portion, and it shows streaming movement or cyclosis, means it keeps on flowing, it do not remain stagnant. And all the other parts of the amoeba, including nucleus, food vacuoles, contractile vacuole, and all the cell organelles, mitochondria, endoplasmic reticulum, etc., all of them, they are present in the plasma sole only. So plasma sole is the largest or the most abundant part in amoeba. You all must be knowing that amoeba, it has an irregular shape, or it do not have any fixed morphology, and that is due to presence of numerous temporary finger-like projections on its surface, which are called as pseudopodia. And pseudopodia, in case of amoeba, they are blunt, means pseudopodia ke jo edges honge, jo uske tips honge, wo sharp nahi honge, blunt uske tips honge, and pseudopodia, it consists of both ecto and the endoplasm. The ectoplasm at the very tip of each pseudopodium, it is comparatively thicker, and this thick part of ectoplasm is termed as hyaline cap. So such pseudopodium, which is blunt and has both ecto and endoplasm, is termed as lobopodium. Before continuing further with the locomotion, let us first take a look at the different types of pseudopodia present in other protozoans. So first classification is on the basis of the number of pseudopodia present on the surface. The first, they are polypodia, which means many pseudopodia are present on the surface of organism, and second is monopodia, which means at a time only single pseudopodium can be formed. Second classification is on the basis of the structure, out of which the first is lobopodia, which we just did in case of amoeba, which means the pseudopodium is blunt and consists of both ecto and endoplasm. Next is phylopodia, which are very fine and filamentous pseudopodia, and the pseudopodium in this case, it consists only of ectoplasm, it do not have endoplasm. The pseudopodia, they may be branched, but they do not show network formation. And the next are the reticulopodia, which are also called as rhizopodia, which are again consist of only ectoplasm, but the characteristic feature of this is that pseudopodia, they undergo fusion and they take a sort of network formation. Means yahan par pseudopodia jo hai wo network formation karenge reticulopodia ke case mein. And the last are the exopodia, which are needle like pseudopodia, and the main characteristic feature of exopodia is that each pseudopodium is stabilized by a very fine axial filament. Har ek pseudopodia ke andar ek axial filament uske andar present hoga. So these are the different types of pseudopodia present in case of protozoans. Coming back to the locomotion in case of amoeba, with help of pseudopodium, the specific type of movement of amoeba is termed as amoeboid movement, which is very slow creeping type of movement. Means amoeba जो है वो solid substratum के ऊपर creep करेगा, और इस तरह के movement को हम amoeboid movement बोलते हैं, which is comparatively slow type of movement which takes place at the rate of 0.2 to 0.3 micron meter per second. Creeping movement or the amoeboid movement is not swimming type movement, unlike the movement which are shown by paramecium and euglena, जिनमें cilia और flagellum present होते हैं. Cilia और flagellum की वजह से mostly organism swimming movement show कर पाते हैं, but this amoeboid movement with help of pseudopodium is a creeping type movement on the solid substratum. Coming to the mechanism of the amoeboid movement, numerous theories they have been given for explaining its mechanism, but out of all these, this last sole gel theory is most valid, or it is most widely accepted one, which we will study in this detail in this topic. So this sole gel theory, it was for the first time put forward by Hyman, and the most important or the basic point of sole gel theory is that is the reversible nature of the protoplasm or the sole gel. तो जो sole जो protoplasm होता है amoeba के केस में, it contains numerous actin and myosin proteins which are comparable to the actin and myosin which are present in the muscles of the higher organism. तो actin और myosin इनमें से दो जो actin proteins हैं, they can be present in the protoplasm in two states. One, actin in form of individual actin subunit. तो जब ये actin protein individual actin subunits के form में present होगा, तो जो protoplasm होगा या cytoplasm होगा या endoplasm होगा precisely, it is in the state of sole. It is comparatively fluidy state, और उसको हम बोलेंगे plasma, sole हम उसको बोलेंगे. और जब ये actin के subunits polymerize करके चेन के फॉर्म में माइक्रोफिलामेंट्स वो बनाएंगे, तो द साइटोप्लाज्म इट गेट्स अ कंपैरेटिवली जिलेटिनस स्टेट टू विच वी कॉल एज प्लाज्मा जेल. तो इसका मतलब है कि प्लाज्मा सोल जो है वो प्लाज्मा जेल में कन्वर्ट हो सकता है, एंड वाइस वर्सा. तो दिस प्लाज्मा, देर आर टू इंपॉर्टेंट टर्म्स हेयर, वन इज जिलेशन एंड अदर इज सोलेशन. तो फर्स्ट दिस जिलेशन, इट मीन्स कन्वर्शन ऑफ प्लाज्मा सोल by the process of polymerization into plasma gel. Means gelation is the formation of plasma gel, and vice versa, solation is the formation of plasma sol by depolymerization of the plasma gel or these actin microfilament. So this is the most basic point of the Hyman's theory. So jab bhi aapko exam mein ye theory ke bare mein agar aapko padhna hai, to this is the most important part to understand the sol, the mechanism of the amoeboid movement. So now let us take a look at the mechanism. How do this amoeboid movement it occurs? So this diagram, this is only of single pseudopodium. जैसे अभी हमने करा कि amoeba में at a time ज़्यादा pseudopodia हो सकते हैं, but in this diagram we are only in context to a single pseudopodium. So say this is the direction to which the organism it has to move. तो सबसे पहले तो क्या होगा, जस्ट बिलो द हाइलाइन कैप, हाइलाइन कैप विच इज़ द एक्टोप्लाज्म. तो हाइलाइन कैप के बिल्कुल नीचे एट द टिप ऑफ द सूडोपोडियम दिस प्लाज्मा जेल इट अंडरगो सोलेशन. मीन्स प्लाज्मा जेल जो है वो थोड़ा सा डिसॉल्व होके प्लाज्मा सोल में कन्वर्ट हो जाएगा. तो दिस इज द फर्स्ट थिंग व्हाट हैपन्स. सेकेंड थिंग व्हाट हैपन्स इज द contraction in the gel. This part of the this protoplasm we call it as gel tube, हम इसको बोलते हैं. दिस जिसमें बहुत सारे actin और myosin filaments present हैं. तो ये actin और myosin proteins they undergo sliding movement, जिसकी वजह से there occurs contraction in the plasma lima or in the gel tube. और इस कॉन्ट्रेक्शन की वजह से दिस फ्लूडी प्लाज्मा सोल इट स्टार्ट्स फ्लोइंग फॉरवर्ड. इसको आप कंपेयर कर सकते हैं, जैसे आप टूथपेस्ट के ट्यूब को अगर आप प्रेस करेंगे, तो विद दैट प्रेशर द टूथपेस्ट इट फ्लोस इन फॉरवर्ड इन अ पर्टिकुलर डायरेक्शन. तो सेम दिस प्लाज्मा फ्लूडी प्लाज्मा सोल इट स्टार्ट्स फ्लोइंग इन द फॉरवर्ड डायरेक्शन ड्यू टू विच द सूडोपोडियम इट प्रोसीड्स फॉरवर्ड, इट इलोंगेट्स. इसके साथ साथ दो प्रोसेसेस यहाँ पे होंगी. वन इज जिलेशन, कॉन्टिन्यूस जिलेशन विच अकर्स एट द पेरीफ्री ऑफ द सूडोपोडियम. सूडोपोडियम के टिप पर जिलेशन नहीं होगा, सूडोपोडियम के पेरीफ्री में कॉन्टिन्यूसली सोल इट गेट्स कन्वर्टेड इंटू प्लाज्मा जेल, और ये जो जेल ट्यूब है ये इलोंगेट करती जाएगी आगे की तरफ को. एंड अदर इज सोलेशन विच अकर्स एट द पोस्टीरियर एंड ऑफ द सूडोपोडियम. पीछे की तरफ को कॉन्टिन्यूसली प्लाज्मा जेल जो है वो सोल में कन्वर्ट होता रहेगा, तो पीछे की तरफ को सोलेशन होती रहेगी. देन दिस प्लाज्मा लीमा और दिस जेल ट्यूब इट अंडरगोज कॉन्ट्रेक्शन, जिसकी वजह से प्लाज्मा सोल इट फ्लोज फॉरवर्ड एंड पेरीफ्री पर जिलेशन होता रहेगा. एंड ड्यू टू विच दिस फॉरवर्ड मूवमेंट ऑफ प्लाज्मा सोल दिस सूडोपोडियम इट कॉन्टिन्यूसली कीप्स ऑन मूविंग फॉरवर्ड. सो दिस इज द मैकेनिज्म एक्सप्लेन बाय हाइमिन इन द सोल जेल थ्योरी. एंड नाउ लेट अस टेक with help of this simple diagram the process of amoeboid movement in case of amoeba. So this is said in the initial stage this amoeba it has only these two pseudopodia and both of these they are attached to the substratum. Jaise abhi humne kara with the continuous movement of the plasma sole, forward movement of the plasma sole, there arises a bulge or a new pseudopodium jahan pe humne usko C term diya hai. And this C pseudopodium with time it keeps on growing, it keeps on elongated, and after a certain period of time, after attaining a certain length, it also attaches to the substratum. और उसके बाद फिर क्या होगा, अगेन दिस प्लाज्मा सोल इट कीप्स ऑन मूविंग फॉरवर्ड एंड अगेन अ न्यू सूडोपोडियम इज फॉर्म्ड हेयर. बट एंड वन मोर थिंग इट अकर्स दैट दिस ओल्ड सूडोपोडियम से दिस ए सूडोपोडियम इट डिटैचेस फ्रॉम द सबस्ट्रेटम एंड अगेन दिस न्यू सूडोपोडियम इज इट अगेन अटैचेज एंड बाय दिस टाइम दिस द फर्स्ट सूडोपोडियम इट इज कम्प्लीटली वैनिश्ड. सो दिस इज द क्रीपिंग टाइप और द अमीबॉइड मूवमेंट हम इसको बोलते हैं इन केस ऑफ अमीबा. सो दैट इज ऑल अबाउट द लोकोमोशन विद हेल्प ऑफ सूडोपोडियम इन केस ऑफ अमीबा. बट अपार्ट फ्रॉम हेल्पिंग इन लोकोमोशन सूडोपोडियम दे ऑल्सो प्ले अनदर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल इन केस ऑफ अमीबा. दैट इज दे हेल्प इन फीडिंग बाय कैप्चरिंग इट्स फूड by the process of phagocytosis. So this diagram it explains the process of phagocytosis in case of amoeba, in which again pseudopodia they play very important role. So I hope you all have understood this topic of locomotion with help of pseudopodium in case of amoeba, and that is all for today's lecture. Thank you.